Hello everyone, my name is Vimal Raj. I'm a lecturer from James Polytechnic College, Aurangabad, Bihar. I'm from the department Mechanical. So today we're going to discuss on the unit number 5, that is non-metallic materials. And this is lecture number 23. And this is about the introduction to polymers. So this is from the subject called Mechanical Engineering Materials. And the subject code is 1625304. Contents that we're going to discuss today is introduction to polymers. So basically today we'll be seeing about what is polymers and what are the types of polymers. So introduction. In engineering applications, we often come across the use of various types of polymeric materials. So these materials are comparatively cheaper and already replace a lot of metals in our day-to-day life. So they are corrosion resistant, low weight, and versatility in shape and size. So basically, if I want to give an introduction about the polymers, we all know that in the earlier days, people used to buy two-wheelers, that is bikes. So when you see bike, if you take a bullet bike and all, they will be doing the bike with the metal. But nowadays, if you see, the total metal parts have been totally been replaced with this kind of polymers. So in our day-to-day life itself, we can see our daily needs and all, it's been totally changed. Wherever the metal was there, it has been totally been replaced by polymers. So that is also one of the reasons, as well as it has some of the good qualities like corrosion resistance. Basically, if we take iron or other things, iron has a corrosive property. So if suppose water is poured on continuously, it might tend to go corrosive in nature, salt water, some of the things. But if you take the plastics or polymers, they are good towards the corrosion resistance, as well as they are low, less in weight. So instead of putting 2 kg of polymer, 2 kg of metal, we can introduce 2 kg of polymers, by which it will occupy much more spaces. And the best thing is reshaping of iron is very, very difficult. But when you go with the polymers, reshaping is very, very easy because the versatility in the shape and size is there with the polymer, so that whenever or wherever we want, we can reshape it as we want, only we have to do the heating process. So that is the introduction about the polymers. Definition of a polymer. So a polymer is a chemical substance. So basically a polymer is a chemical substance which is made up of repeating units of molecules to form a long flexible chain. So this is actually a Greek word in which poly means many and mer means a unit. Okay, so having many units is called as polymers. So each repeating unit called as a monomers. So each repeating unit, so that means one unit is formed, right? So that if other unit is also formed, it is called as monomers. So the process of linking the monomers together to form a polymer is called polymerization. So process of linking the monomers. So basically one unit is called as unit. When it is repeated again and again, it is called as monomers. So the process of linking multiple monomers is called as polymerization. The process of linking the monomers together to form a polymer is called as polymerization. The multiple monomers are linked together to form a polymer is called as polymerization. So polymer is actually a Greek word in which poly is many and mer is called as a unit. Okay. So this is structure of a polymer. So in the first, you could see that the above chain, the first and the last mers are made stable by adding a hydrogen atoms. The first and the last, you could see it's a carbon bond, it's a hydrogen bond. So when you see the continuous, so that means this is one unit, this is one unit. When it goes polymerization, so it is like one carbon is having two hydrogen atoms, right? So when it goes a continuous process, it is called the polymerization by opening a double bond. So it goes with a double bond. So here this carbon is having a double bond, right? So this is a unit, so that's single units. So when it goes to this process, it comes as a polymerization. So this is a one unit, this is a one unit, but it goes, right? It forms a polymerization, okay, for the polyethylene will be polyethylene will be formed. This is known as the polyethylene, so plastic materials. So plastics, first we have to know about the properties of plastics. Plastics are light in weight, that is absolutely correct. Plastics are light in weight, so basically they are very light in weight when compared with other metals. So light in weight means so if you take a bike nowadays, all the bikes are coming with plastics only. Plastics in the sense, it's a different type of plastics, so which is very reduced, very reduced in weight, but as well as it has some durability also. But when you compare the bullet bike, which is fully made of iron, what is the difference? The bullet bike weight would be around 300 kg, but the normal bike around 120 kg, so almost around 2 times of the weight has been reduced. So that means the speed, the aerodynamics, the speed will be increasing, as well as the engine capacity can also be reduced, and also because of that the price range also can be decreased. So if we want to ride a bullet bike, at least we need to have a more than 350 cc of engine, then only it can be ride, I mean can be used, because the power has to be pulling the total weight of the vehicle. So that is very very important. So that is the reason plastic is very light in weight, so that we can reduce the manufacturing cost. Next one, it has, they are very soft, and so they are soft as compared to metals. So they are very very soft when they are compared to metals. And plastics have very low tensile and compressive strength, that means the tensile strength is very low, so that breakage can happen, right? Because it's light in weight and it's flexible, so because of that compressive strength is very less, so it cannot bear the impact, greater impact on compressive strength like that. And it is very tensile, tensile strength also very low. So they are excellent heat and electrical insulator. So basically they are excellent in heat and electrical insulator, so very much heat cannot pass over it, and it's a good electrical insulator, because current also cannot pass through it. And one more thing is they have high corrosion resistance. The corrosion is very very important, because when you take a bullet bike, if you keep the bullet bike in the rain for about a week, and if you don't use it for more than a month, if you go and see the bike, you will see that the rusty things will be forming on the top of the bike. But if you keep a bike which is having only the plastic things, even if you're not using for about 6 months, only the dust will be there. So just if you wipe it, no corrosion will happen. So it has a high corrosion resistance. Next one is they offer excellent resistance to acids. Basically, it will not react to any acids, alcohols or alkalis. So that is also one of the good signs. And the next one is the types of plastics. So we have thermoplastics, thermosetting plastics, elastomers, that is called rubber. So we will be discussing about all those things in the upcoming slides, as well as some of the topics we'll be covering in the next video. Thermoplastics. So thermoplastic is nothing but substance which lose their rigidity whenever they are heated. So that means it will lose its rigidity whenever it is heated, so that they can be molded under pressure with the new shape being retained on cooling. So basically what happens is this thermoplastics is a substance which loses rigidity continuously whenever it is heated. So whenever you heat this plastic, it will lose its rigidity, so that you can reshape it as you want, so that it can be molded under pressure and the new shape being retained on a cooling. So that's what how. So this is something which is very very easy, right? So if we have a thermoplastic, means we can, it's like a clay. If you want to make a dog, we can make it. If you want to make a penguin, we can make it. So likewise, we can heat this thermoplastic, we can reshape it. Once the shape is done, if you want to change the shape, we can again heat it and we can again mold it, and again we can make it cool and we can get a different shape. So which is something very very important, which is very very easy as well. So this are also known as thermosoftening plastics. So basically this is also called as thermosoftening plastics. So where in which thermoplastics can be reshaped with a softened state. So where in which thermoplastics is reshaped with a stopped and says, thus the scrap can be used again and again. So basically this scrap can be used again and again. So these scraps can be used again and again. So they may become too soft to use at temperature from 60 to 325 degrees Celsius. So basically they may become too soft to use at a temperature from 60 to 325 degrees Celsius. So they have a linear structure, i.e. cellulose, nylons, polyethylene, resins, vinyl plastics, etc. So they have the linear structure. So there are some linear structures in this plastic substance. So the properties, they have excellent tensile strength, about 600 megapascals. Okay. And next one is good compressive strength, about 150 megapascals. So these plastics have a tensile strength as well as a compressive strength and excellent machinability. Machinability is it can be machined at any point of time because it is very, very easy to be machined and very good chemical resistance because it will not be reacting to any chemicals. Basically, it is a chemical. So this is how the thermoplastic works. So commonly used thermoplastics are acrylic. So acrylic, I think most of the people would have listened to acrylic painting, all those things, right? So the full name of acrylic is a polymethyl methacrylate. Okay, so it is also known as plexiglass as a lucite, plexiglass as a lucite. So it is a transparent with excellent clarity and high index of refraction. So basically it has a high index of refraction, it has a high index of refraction, and it has a transparent with excellent clarity. So basically it has a good clarity as well as. So it can be shaped easily and widely used in a sheet form. So this can be made into a sheet form. So it is light in weight, so it is nice and light in weight and tough but easily scratched. So this is something which is very, very different. It is light in weight and it is tough but easily scratched. So application in fiber optics, so in fiber optics, if you see nowadays everywhere you see the fiber internet connection. So they use this fiber optics method. So that is the acrylic which can use in fiber optics. Contact lenses. Mm-hmm. How many of you used contact lenses? So the lens which is made with the acrylic. So this is the contact lenses. Transparent bowls, even the transparent bowls, drink dispensers, etc. So if you go in airport or station hall, drinking dispenser will be there, right? So that also comes out of this acrylic. This one is in nylon, so also known as polymeters, nylotron, nylophil, and plascon. So it can be molded successfully and extracted, formed into sheet as well as thin film. So these nylons can be formed into a sheet as well as a thin film and can be casted easily. So that means it can also be casted easily and it is strong. So it has a good durability. It is tough and light in weight. So basically it is strong, tough and light in weight. So it has low coefficient of friction. So the coefficient of friction is very, very less, like a ball bearing. Previously we discussed it, ball bearing has a low coefficient of friction. It also has a low coefficient of friction and it is excellent to heat. So basically it is excellent towards heat. So and abrasion. So excellent to heat means it's a good conductor of electricity, I mean heat. And abrasion is there. So we know what is abrasive materials and chemical reaction as well, because this is a nylon. So it can be chemically reacted. Applications is for manufacturing of films. So films is nothing but in the olden days we used a camera where the camera rolls will be there, right? That is called the films. That is in the bearings. See, I was talking about the bearings. Bearings, gears. Because of the low coefficient of friction is there, so they use the gears. And machine slides also will be used. And the clothing ropes, nylon ropes are there, right? In our house, we used to tie these ropes for drying the brushes and brush bristles, etc. So the bristles that is there in the brush, that is also made up of nylon. Okay. So with that, we just come to the conclusion of this video. So today we are discuss about what is polymer and types of plastics. And these are the reference book, guys. So thank you, guys. Thank you for seeing this video. So we will cover the next topics in the next video. Hope you guys see you in the next video. Thank you, guys.